crazy new character decision coming to Smash Bros. Ultimate, and we break down who might be next. Let's talk all about it. What's happening, my Blocked buddies, and welcome to a brand new episode of Blocked Content's Leak Speak. My name is Callum, and this is going to be your content for today, and I'm super happy to be making this episode. A lot of great things have been happening, a lot of awesome things have been happening in the world of Super Smash Bros. Ultimate, and I wanted to take the time to break it all down for you guys. Of course, a new year, brand new chances for characters that you guys are super excited about. The DLC, we have three characters left, and it seems like every day we get a little bit more of an idea what people want these characters to be, kind of what the general consensus is for the fans, but also what Sakurai might be cooking up in the kitchen over there. So yes, Super Smash Bros. Ultimate's next DLC fighters may already be known. So we'll break all of that information down today too, because that is something that you guys have been sending me a lot of messages about, very excited to find out who's next. But also there's this crazy leak that I really wanted to touch upon, because it really talks about a character that I couldn't have seen coming from a mile away, right? This is a character that just doesn't make sense in my head, but it's also something that really speaks to Sakurai, right? These, like, strange IP that he really loves, and like Kid Icarus, right? We haven't heard from the character a long time, and then he got into Brawl, and then of course now it's one of people's favorite video game characters because that game was just so incredibly cool, and his inclusion in Smash Bros. Has been really a fan favorite for a long time. Well, something like that might also be happening in the very nearby future. This is some very exciting stuff. I don't know how believable it is, but of course this is Blocked Content, where we discuss all of it, and we don't really take anything for granted. We take everything with a grain of salt, and we just discuss it, because what is more than just dreaming away at the possibilities of what is possible in the world of the biggest crossover game of all time? And of course, I've been answering many of you guys' questions about Smash Ultimate and new fighters in our show Question Blocked, where I answer your questions. What do I think of your favorite game? How do you start making YouTube content? Whatever you can think of, send your question through to blockedcontentmail@gmail.com, and I will answer your question live on the show in our next Question Blocked episode. So I want to first dive into all this crazy stuff pertaining to this leak, and it's a doozy. So let's talk all about it. It first talks about a couple of different characters that you might not even know. Yes, characters that seem so out of the blue that some of the fans might not even have any idea where these are coming from. Well, they actually got a trophy in Smash Brothers, so let's talk about it. Okay, this leak says, so it's time to tell you about Challenger Pack 9. First off, I am one of the video editors for Nintendo's Smash Bros. Presentations and, on some instances, reveal trailers. I'm not gonna go over where I am, what I do, or what division I'm in, for obvious personal reasons. And of course this reads like, yeah, I'll definitely get fired if you let me know, right? The point is, I oversee everything in terms of video editing. That is a very interesting job title. Please give it to me, right? He says, Sakurai and the rest of the staff in Japan just recently finished up recording the raw footage for Fighter 9, and we've already been given the specifics of what to include in the presentation and in what order. So, right, these would be editing notes for these guys to, like, actually put together the video and make it interesting, right? In one whole fell swoop. Believe it or not, the actual development for Fighter 9 is closer done than you think. The Mii costumes are already made. The character seems fully rigged, so that may be good to know. As for who Fighter 9 is, it's going to be someone completely unexpected. It is a Game Freak rep that surprisingly is not a Pokemon. Fighter 9 will be Tempo from Harmonite, a rhythm-based venture on the 3DS that died out about 8 years ago. From the first set of raw footage, Masahiro Sakurai seems to have personally wanted Tempo in the game since Super Smash Bros. For Wii U and 3DS. As for why Tempo is being added as a fighter, I don't know. Is Harmonite getting revived? I don't know. Unfortunately, my ties don't get me far. Then going on to say, I'm not going to tell you the character's moveset because I personally can't understand it myself, but he seems to tie in rhythm and music to his moveset really well. Next are the Mi costumes. One deluxe Mi, relax, no major character gets deconfirmed, and it goes on to list the Mi costumes. Tappy, Gargan, Lloyd Irving, and Mythos Idrisil. Our deluxe Mi, Cinderace, who surprisingly comes with a head unlike a certain Pinocchio boy, and yes, sorry if anyone wanted Cinderace or Gino. I have no idea when the reveal trailer will air or when we're supposed to put out the presentation, but the fighter itself seems to have a release date of March the 2nd, which would be, well, very, very soon. So, a lot of interesting stuff here to break down. Harmonite is, of course, a pretty interesting game. I think that it's so cool that Game Freak went out of their way to, like, do something crazy, do something new. So, I like that. And I don't know. It's one of those out there picks that, yeah, someone could just be making this up just to look legitimate because, well, these weird choices are something that happens in real life sometimes. So, we'll have to wait and see to find out if any of this is actually real. Now, going on to talk more about what could be next for Smash Bros. Ultimate, is an article from ScreenRant.com, which is originally posted by J. Brody Sheary, and it says Super Smash Bros. Ultimate's next DLC fighters may already be known. The next round of DLC guest fighters for Super Smash Bros. Ultimate might have been leaked by an anonymous source, one that has been right before. And it goes on to say that a leak provides a hint as to who will be included in the next round of Super Smash Bros. Ultimate DLC characters, and it's a pair that fans have been wanting for some time. As of this writing, there is still one more wave of fighters set to arrive in Nintendo's hit crossover fighting game before developer Masahiro Sakurai is set to be retiring, but that is still a couple of years off. In the meantime, Super Smash Bros. Ultimate has had a busy 2020 when it came to new fighter announcements. The fun began with the reveal of Byleth from Fire Emblem Three Houses last January, followed by Arms' Min Min in June and Minecraft's Steve in October. To cap off the year, Final Fantasy VII baddie Sephiroth was unveiled at December's Game Awards livestream in a stunning reveal trailer, joining his arch-nemesis Cloud Strife among the pantheon of gaming mascots battling it out in colorful multiplayer combat. According to comicbook.com, a new leak might have been revealed for the next two Super Smash Bros. Ultimate combatants. This anonymous account, translated from Japanese message board 5ch.net, today claims that two heroes from the Tales of franchise, namely Tales of Symphonia's Lloyd Irving and Tales of Vesperia's Riri Lowell, are set to be coming to the game sometime next year. This leak also provided some unverified insight towards characters that were considered in the past, like Street Fighter's Chun-Li, who was turned down in favor of Ken Masters, and Sora of Kingdom Hearts fame, who was abandoned after Square Enix didn't feel comfortable having him appear in the game without any Disney characters. Fan speculation regarding which popular gaming icons will be next to appear in Super Smash Bros. Ultimate are commonplace among the series fanbase, with the most popular candidates being Halo's legendary space soldier Master Chief, Crash Bandicoot, and even Tracer and Doomfist from Overwatch. Sure enough, Lloyd and Yuri are among the heroes that some fans have been requesting, alongside the aforementioned Sora. As such, both having Lloyd Irving and Yuri Lowell to be announced as the next Smash Bros. Ultimate guest fighters would be a treat for the fans of their JRPG adventures, and they could fit right in with similar stars like Cloud and Shulk of the Xenoblade Chronicles series. Even better, previous leaks have correctly predicted characters like Steve, though this could have been more of a lucky guess. Absolutely nothing regarding the next wave of Super Smash Bros. Ultimate DLC fighters has been officially confirmed so far, so fans should stay tuned for more concrete developments as they should unfold on a future date. So yes, I mean, it does really make sense. It's so funny that Lloyd Irving was named in this leak and also the previous one that we discussed. So much to break down. I'm really curious about you guys' thoughts about all of this. Let me know in the comments down below. If you comment down below, that could actually be featured and read out loud in our next video. And today's comment question is, what is your crazy out there prediction for a character that no one can see coming? And as for a previous comment question winner, our answer comes to us from our user John R, saying, I would be perfectly fine without Chun-Li. She's on that list of 40 characters, I just want to point that out, but she would be a Capcom rep, which means Dante and Phoenix Wright could probably not get in. Also, it would be a little strange to have two female characters both from fighting ending games in one pass. I'm not saying it is impossible, but it seems unlikely. I would think that they would try and mix it up just a little bit. If only there were another iconic female character on that list that isn't already in Smash in some form. Oh wait, there is. Are you talking about Shantae, John? Well, very curious. Let me know in the comments down below who you want to have in one of those three seats. Thank you guys so much for sending in your comments. These are always a ton of fun to read through. And of course, a huge shout out to our latest Patreon supporters and the super chats you guys send during live streams. You guys make Block content possible. So if you want to have yourself created in Block content style, join me for a live discussion, or even have your own ideas become animations, go to patreon.com/blockedcontent. There's a bunch of incredible rewards there, and they're waiting for you. And remember, if you are not yet a member of the Blocked Content family yet, hit subscribe now, smash that like button, and ring the bell for notifications, and all the news and fun you care about will be delivered on the daily to you. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you around the corner with, as always, more Blocked Content. See ya!